This is Carson Palmer, and you're watching Cyber Golf Television.
Coming up on Cyber Golf Front 9, we goes from the farm to the farm, the underrated world of college golf. My shot lands on the silent cheers at Augusta National, and Trevor made the top 10 list. Cyber Golf Front 9 starts now. Welcome to Cyber Golf Front 9. I'm your host, Matt Biondi. Michelle Wee has landed another sponsor's exemption for the summer. She'll play in the State Farm Classic 1 week after playing in another LPGA event in Ohio. She's currently rehabbing an injury. The next tournament is set for May. College golf continues to be one of the best kept secrets out there. And in effect, that's one of the problems with it. Recently, Cyber Golf TV asked one NCAA college coach to reflect on the state of the game and where it's at right now.
It's a secret. I tell everybody it's our fault, the coaches, because most of the events we kind of run them ourselves. And so we don't do a good job marketing them or making them available to the public very well. But it's a great product because you have the future stars of the PGA Tour that someday you're going to travel all over and pay money to watch, and you can walk right along with them. And there's no ropes out here. You can really get close to the action. And you know, every tournament that you go to that's in college, you've got some future PGA Tour players.
Now my shot. And as exciting as the Masters was, it seemed to be lacking something this year. And then it dawned on me, those thunderous roars on the back nine on Sunday afternoon. We received one when Tiger dropped his bomb, but the rest of the time the field was playing for par. That's of course because of the wind difficulties, but also the way the golf course was set up. Granted, the tees were moved up a bit, but something was lacking. It seemed to me more like a US Open than a classic Masters. So what does the Masters champion do after winning at Augusta National? Hops on an airplane, heads to New York City, and reads the Letterman top 10 list of reasons why Trevor Immelman's life has changed since winning at Augusta. And the number one reason? He gets to go up to Tiger Woods and say, maybe next year. Now it's time for the Cyber Golf Front 9 quiz, and our question today is this. The week after the Masters is the PGA event at Hilton Head, South Carolina. Who's won the most amount of tournaments at that venue? Log on to cybergolf.com, possibly win our Cyber Golf Front 9 prize. That's a wrap for Cyber Golf Front 9. I'm your host, Matt Biondi. Keep it in the short grass. We'll see you tomorrow, everyone.